He was fired for this. Punching, grabbing, and kicking his players. But Mike Rice, whose annual salary was just increased to $750,000, also will get a $100,000 bonus for staying with Rutgers through the end of this season. Had he been fired when university officials found out about this video, he wouldn't have gotten the bonus. Amid calls for the dismissal of the athletic director, some Rutgers faculty members are so fired up, they're calling for the university president, Robert Barchi, to step down.
We're a great university. But I think our president does not uphold our values as a university.
The investigation into Rice's behavior began as the university was vying for membership in the Big Ten.
I don't see how we can stand in front of our students and say that we do this research, but when it comes to Big Ten money and when it comes to sports and getting in the Big Ten, that all those things go out the window, and you can call people the filthiest, most homophobic and misogynistic words. And that's okay, because this is about sports. Sports is not separate from education.
Now the focus is on who at the university knew what and when. In an interview Tuesday, athletic director Tim Pernetti said this.
I was aware of the tape when I handed down the suspension at the end of December.
Did your president see this tape?
Yes.
But in a statement released yesterday, Barchi said he watched the video for the first time Tuesday. Our attempts to reach Pernetti and Barchi at the university were unsuccessful.
No, ma'am, not today.
As the fallout grows, some of Rice's former players are saying the video is not what it seems.
A lot of those times on the film when he was jacking up a player or throwing a ball at a player, he was really joking.
Still, some faculty members want to garner more support for a letter demanding greater accountability on the part of athletic director Tim Pernetti. Also in the state capitol, there are calls for a legislative investigation into what happened here on campus.